Good morning. My science breakfast today will be an orange marmalade with strawberries that I already prepared here for him. And then I will be having a toast with peanut butter. And I already made myself a smoothie that it has strawberry, aloe vera, and almond milk. So in a little bit, I will be sharing with you what else we are gonna be doing. Okay, I already finished with breakfast and made the beds, also vacuumed the carpet, and now I'm just gonna relax a little bit before I take my son to the dentist, and then I'm gonna have lunch. But the most important thing that I wanna share today in this video, it is about a place that I will take my son and his friend, which is an animal shelter, because they wanna see dogs. And because I was thinking, you know, I'm gonna share with you all, and especially if you are trying to buy a dog and you can afford it because you have the money and you are looking for a specific dog that you wanted to buy, and you might think that the shelter, the animal shelter, might not have it. Because the idea of some people is that the shelters are not always having the cutest dogs, usually the ones that are too old or the ones that are not cute. But I'm gonna prove different, because I'm gonna show you this shelter, this animal shelter here in Rancho Cucamonga, that it has beautiful dogs, all types of different races. I don't know how you say it. No, I don't know. It's not like that. You say it breeds. And if you try to watch this video, you will see how cute the dogs are over there. And you should think twice and reconsider before buying to visit an animal shelter that might be having a dog that needs you, and they might be having a dog that is waiting for you. So if you are trying, and right now you are in that mood of buying a dog for you, please visit different shelters. If they don't have the puppy that you are looking for, then just do as you want. But before buying, please try to see this video, try to see these animals that are waiting for a family like you that is looking for a dog, for a puppy. So, you know, I rescued two dogs, and I made the mistake once to buy a dog. I did not know about shelters, about animal shelters, when I first came to this country. So I was in the mall with my son while he was a baby, a toddler actually, and I found this beautiful store selling all type of beautiful dogs. And the prices were around $2,000 and $1,500, $1,800, all those expensive prices for a dog. So after looking for a few days in the same mall, I ended up buying a dog for my son. I spent a lot of money. I regret it, because you know how it is, when you have money, it is easy not to think too much. And if you like something, you buy it, you get it. So, but the mistake, it wasn't only on the money that I spent, it was on the cruelty of doing that. You know why? Because dogs are beautiful, all of them. It depends on the personality of the dog, but I believe that every dog has a unique and beautiful personality. So years later, somehow, I don't know who let me know about the shelters, and I visit different ones. And obviously I end up rescuing, but I'm not like a dog lover responsibility. I love dogs, but the responsibility kind of end up, I don't know how to explain it. Responsibility of the dog as a single mom with my son, it was too much. So to make the story short, as I shared in one of my videos, I end up giving up my two dogs to my father. So now we visit the dogs when my father comes over, or when we go visit him, which is rarely. Most of the time he comes home and he brings the dog, and I take responsibility of the dogs like I promised my father when I gave it to him, when I gave them to him. So I give them baths and I walk them around. Obviously my father loves dogs. For him, dogs are the only, I believe that that's all he loves, dogs in his life. So for him, these dogs are everything to him. So I am happy that I gave these dogs to him, because he knows how to give them the whole attention that the dog needs from you. I did not have the time for that. Even though that I was very patient and I had them for 2 years, each one of them. So this is the first year that my son and me, we are without a dog, basically. So the reason that I'm sharing this is because I did not know, nobody told me about the animal shelters. So I had to discover this along the way and thought of myself, like, even if I had money again, I will never ever again buy a dog. I don't care what type of dog it is, how special, how exotic, or how perfect the dog is, I will never buy a dog again. After being in these shelters, meaning, it changed my mind completely. So if you are one of those persons that can afford anything you want, please go to a shelter and rescue a dog. There are many different shelters in each city here in California, where I am living right now. So I will just show you now one of the shelters that is located here in Rancho Cucamonga. And this shelter has 79 dogs available and puppies, I don't know how many. So I will be showing you these dogs that are available and ready to find a home, basically. So it is kind of sad, you don't want to enter to those places because, first of all, these dogs should not be expensive either. In the shelter, they cost like $100 or $150 for a puppy. For a big dog, it's $100 to take it home. But there are different requirements. You have to prove from your landlord that you can own this dog and fill up different papers. You know, it's kind of, they don't make it easy for you. And nowadays, in California, all the shelters are under maximum capacity because of the same reason. They make it kind of difficult for you to adopt a dog, but still worth it, because if you are determined to have a dog, this is not gonna be a big deal for you to do. But also, there is another thing here in California. I don't know how it is in other states. I know that in Nevada, if you wanna own a dog and you live in an apartment complex, you pay $35 rent a month to be able to have your dog in your home. Here in California, it is $50 a month, and I believe it's $100 deposit in order to own a dog. And you have to pay rent for your dog in your own home, $50 a month. So that's why the shelters right now are in over capacity, because it's full of dogs, you know, these laws are making the dogs miserable and us more complicated at the time to adopt a dog for the same reason, you know, because why do we have to pay rent for a dog if we are already paying rent? The dog should not be paying rent. But anyways, things are like this. And I honestly am not in a position to pay rent for a dog right now. I can't. But if you are a pet lover, and it should not matter, you know? If you have the money for it, that's fine, because then you can pay the rent for your dog. But I'm just talking overall, like, even if you have the money, it is unfair that the dogs needs to pay rent. So now even the dogs, I mean, it's just like crazy when you think about it, because it is cruel, you know? It is cruel to see these dogs that are locked up inside of a cage with a beautiful day outside, knowing how much the dog loves to run, loves to be outdoors. You know, the dog is always jumping. Whenever we are getting closer to the door, the dog is already running after us because they want to go outside. They want to be in parks. They want to just be out, basically. So entering in these shelters and seeing these dogs with those sad eyes waiting for a family to rescue them, you know, it makes you feel like, I wish I can do something for these dogs and adopt them all and close down the shelters. So, for example, in my country, there are many dogs that are living alone, you know, just walking alone all over the city, all over the town, basically. And these are street dogs, and they are the sweetest. And people, you know, they still feed them, they still give them water. And they also...
Can you go to the shelter?
Yeah. And okay, so basically, now he's on a chance and we are gonna go to the shelter, so I'm gonna show you these beautiful dogs that I truly hope that you will like one of them and rescue them. So try to watch this video until the end, because it's gonna be cute dogs and coming forward. Yeah. recipes that she got.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
It is so sad because it's like they are in shell. See, that's why I don't like coming to shelters. Here is another pit bull, Alan.
I'm scared of
people. This one is 7 years old.
Oh, look, the boxer. I saw him last time here.
But Alan,
this is the boxer that I was talking about. He's old and he's about to.
See, if I. Sometimes it is worth it to have money. To do rescue.
I want to cry. I feel like crying.
Yeah. This dog is 8 years old.
That's a German Shepherd. Angelina, look at him. They have the golden retrievers here.
This one says, I'm very protective of my puppies. But it is very sad, that's for sure. It is a beautiful sunny day outdoors right now, and these dogs are, like, if they committed kind of a crime, you know, that they have to be in cages, in shell, basically. Like, they are, like, kind of paying a death sentence here.
I feel bad for that one.
So, if you are watching this video, please come to the Rancho Cucamonga Animal Shelter and try to rescue one of these dogs. If you have the opportunity, I wish I had a house, so at least I can rescue one of them. But living in the apartment is kind of impossible.
Okay, there's one more section.
To take care of a big dog. What is it?
I don't want to see another section. Okay, this is
fast. No. Okay, Alan wants to leave because this is too emotional for him. This is too much, actually, for me, for anybody. But the reason that I'm making this video is because it will be nice if you ever come to the city of Rancho Cucamonga, you know, you have all these type of different dogs that you can rescue and give them a happy life.
There's one more section. No, all the big dogs.
These puppies, look at them, all of them together sleeping.
Poor mom, that's the mom that's holding.
Yeah.
Who's going first?
Okay, pretty small.
These are big ones. These are big ones.
You know what, it makes me sad that some of them are not even barking because they know that they are never gonna get out of here. But thinking positive, maybe there is people watching this video. And they will visit Rancho Cucamonga.
Angelina, look, Husky.
And they will come and rescue one of these dogs.
Good Husky.
If you're a dog lover, don't come to this shelter unless it is to rescue one. You will destroy it. Because someone will be watching this video, and if they want to visit Rancho Cucamonga, they can come and rescue a dog. You know, people are always looking for them. They are not available. Why? Why they are not available yet? Because they are too small, right?
Yeah.
So the shelter wants them to spend time with their mom, right?
Yeah, in order to...
Yeah. Pobre, ya la están separando. It's only three puppies left for the mom. And this curtain was closed. Because they're already trying to separate her emotionally, I guess, from her puppies.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of it. I need some distraction.
They are small puppies, they are supposed to be in small cages. It's so ridiculous, it shouldn't be like that. Regardless the size of the dog, they need space and they shouldn't be in these small cages, basically. How old is she? Or he? It's a Chihuahua Shorty mix. Re triste. O sea, it's desperate to get out of here. O sea, no, para, not because it's a small puppy, they should deserve small cages.
This
one, his name is Carter. And it's a boy, it's a male, I'm sorry. It's a male, his name is Carter, and he's 8 years old. No, let's say male. Her name is Tio, and he's 1 year and 1 month old.
So tired of the straight line, and everywhere you turn, vultures and thieves at your back. Storm keeps on twisting. Keep on building lies that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Escape one last time. It's easy. This sweet madness, all this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees in the arms of the angel.